Okay, everybody, we welcome you tonight to our VBS 2023. And this is the Crave Cafe is the theme of this. We're talking about the different types of food in the Bible that represent Jesus. How many remember yesterday we talked about Jesus is what? He's the bread of what? He's the bread of life. That's right. He's the bread of life. Amen. And we want to eat of the bread of life, the living. And also he's known as the living what? The living water. That's right. Praise God. Really glad to have you kids tonight. I tell you what, it has been fantastic. Tuesday night, Wednesday night, and we're going to have a fantastic night tonight. Excited about this. And I know that you realize that in the back there, did you see them blowing up that thing? What's that thing back there called? What is that? Yeah, bouncy slide. You see that back there? And we've got roasted hot dogs tonight. We've got prize giveaway. But we got some really important things to do before that, like this. We're going to worship the Lord. We're going to sing unto God tonight. We're going to praise him. And we've got a special message to give to you tonight, okay? So we're really, really, really glad to have you kids. And I hope you enjoy this. But most of all, I pray that you understand the important message that we're trying to bring to you. And that is that Jesus saves. Amen. Jesus loves you. He wants to forgive you of your sins. He wants to save your soul. And Jesus wants you to hunger and to thirst after him. How many here have ever been really hungry? You ever been hungry before? Sometimes like, oh, I'm starving. I can't wait to get something. And sometimes you go to McDonald's and you get a cheeseburger. Or you go to Taco Bell and you get a burrito. Or you go to the pizza place and you get a pepperoni pizza. And you're like, oh, that tastes so good. And you're so hungry. Remember that? You know what I'm talking about? Well, you know what? Wouldn't it be good if we were that hungry for Jesus, to know him as our personal Lord and Savior, to live our lives for Jesus? Because I'm going to tell you something. He's the one that can change us, amen. And he loves you and he desires for you to live for him. But he's not going to force you and he's not going to make you. But I know this. He desires for you to live for him. So I pray that we'll be hungry for God, okay? Let's be hungry for the Lord. So kiddos, with that said and done, let's stand up together tonight. All right. Praise the Lord. We don't have a green team or yellow team or orange team tonight. We are all on the same team. Yeah. Woo. Hallelujah. We're on the same team. Amen. We're living for Jesus. Remember the green team? We said yesterday we put Jesus first, right? All right. Let's pray, okay? All kids, bow their heads. Stand with me tonight. Kids in the back, stand with me, okay? Kids in the back, stand with me, please. Oh, thank you. Let's pray together. Bow your heads. Everybody quiet, no talking. And let's have reverence for God tonight. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, God, for these wonderful kids. Opportunity we have tonight to be able to worship you and spend time in your presence and to hear the word of the Lord, your purpose and plan for our lives. I pray all these children would really understand and get the message of what this VBS outreach is all about. I pray that they will hunger and thirst after you, Lord, and righteousness and desire to live their lives for you. Change them, help them, lead them, guide them, bless them, Father. Keep them safe, I pray. Help us to be attentive tonight. And God, we give you all the glory, asking for the unction, the anointing, the power of thy spirit upon us in this service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, Abby, are you ready?
I'm ready. Oh. I don't think they're ready, though.
I don't know. Get them ready, Abby. Get them ready.
Are you guys ready? Oh, you guys aren't ready. Are you guys ready? Yeah, you're ready. Let's go ahead and sing.
All right. You guys know this song now, right?
Come all you weary, come all you thirsty, come to the well that never runs dry. Drink of the water, come and thirst no more. Come all you sinners, come find his mercy. Come to the table, he will satisfy. Taste of his goodness, find what you're looking for.
Sing it with us, guys!
For God so loved the world that he gave us his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. Bring all your failures, bring your addictions. Come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting there with open arms. For God so loved the world that he gave us his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, praise him, for the wonders of his love. Praise God, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, praise him, for the wonders. Whoever believes in him will live forever. The power of hell forever defeated. Now it is well. I'm walking in freedom. For God so loved the world. For God so loved the world that he gave us his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. The power of hell forever defeated. Now it is well. I'm walking in freedom. For God so loved the world.
All right, guys, let's sing that again. For God so loved.
For God so loved the world that he gave us his one and only Son to save us. Whoever believes in him will live forever. The power of hell forever defeated. Now it is well. I'm walking in freedom. For God so loved the world. Bring all your failures, bring your addictions. Come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Jesus is waiting, God so loved the world.
You guys sound so good. I am so sad that we are all done with VBS and I can't hear you guys sing anymore. So that's why we're gonna sing one more song. And I don't know if you guys have picked up on the theme of VBS, but we're talking about a lot of food. And the song that we're going to sing is literally called Hungry. So let's all sing this song, and we're going to talk about how hungry we are for Jesus, okay? It goes,
hungry I come to you, for I know you satisfy.
is living for.
You know, the best thing we can do, kids, is give ourselves to Jesus. You know that? And just say, God, I surrender all. I surrender my life and my heart. I surrender all to you, Lord. I'm hungry for you. I want a relationship with you. I want my sins forgiven. And God, I want to live my life for you. You know, that's what Jesus is looking for. God just simply wants you to love him, and he wants you to surrender everything to him and live your life for him. Praise God. Isn't that a great thing to do, kids? At a young age like this, praise God, you can be a Samuel. You can be a Samuel where you just dedicate your life to God. You dedicate your heart to God. At a young age, Samuel served the Lord, and you can serve God too. You know that? You can have a heart like David that was a young man, a man after God's own heart. That's what God's looking for today. That's what God desires today, okay? You may be seated tonight, kids. I tell you right now, the greatest thing you can ever do is give your heart and life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. Thank you, worship team. Aren't they wonderful folk? Aren't they great, kids? They are fantastic. And these are your teachers. Did you know they're involved in ministry? They're involved in the church, very heavily involved in the church. They work very hard for the Lord, and they serve God, I mean, with their lives and with their hearts. And it's wonderful. Okay, we got a couple things here real quick here tonight. First of all, just let me remind you that the next two Wednesdays, we will not have Rangers or Missionettes. Remember this. The next two Wednesdays, we will not have Rangers or Missionettes, okay? Remember that. Remember. What did I just say? The next two Wednesdays, we don't have what? Rangers or Missionettes. Okay. All right. We know that Fair Week is coming up, and next week we won't be having it, okay? So just let you know, okay? Real quick here. Remember we had some questions about jokes. Who said jokes? Who said that? Well, they all have to do with fruit, and we talk about the fruit of the Spirit, things like this. But let me just ask you a question here. What is a carrot detective especially good at? What's a carrot detective? Go ahead and tell me the answer. What do you think?
Eyesight.
Eyesight. That's a good answer. Eyesight's a good answer. Okay. How about this? Getting to the root of the problem. Isn't that good? Huh? Oh, come on, guys. That's good, right? How about this? Oh, come on now. Why did the banana go to the doctor? Why did the banana go to the doctor? Tell me. He said it wasn't peeling well. He's right. Oh, my goodness. Okay. Let me see. Let me have some help over here. Young man, you come on up here. Come on up here. In the black shirt, blue shirt, come on up here, all right? Come on up real quick here. I want you to help me out with this one. Hurry, run up here, okay? All right. Can you read this right here? What is one fruit that can't cheer you up?
What is one fruit that can't cheer you up?
What is one fruit that can't cheer you up?
A blueberry.
Come on, guys. All right. A blueberry. I need one more volunteer in the back over there. I need someone. Yep. Come on. Someone in the back over there in the back. Wait. Hold on. In the back. I need one of you guys. Where's Landon? Where are you at? Landon, are you back there? Come here, Landon. I know you're here real quick. All right.
Two pickles fell out of a jar. What did one say to the other? Say it real loud. Two pickles fell out of the jar.
Two pickles fell out of the jar. Out of a jar. What did one say to the other?
What did two pickles fell out of the jar? What did one say to the other? What did one say to the other?
Deal with it.
Deal with it.
Deal with it. Huh? That's good stuff. That's good stuff. All right. Those are fun, okay? Let me just say this. What do you call a group of strawberries playing guitar? What do you call a group of strawberries playing guitar? What? A jam session. Oh, yeah. Jam session. One more. Elijah, come here. One more. Elijah, run up here. Run up here to curtain number one.
Where do hamburgers go to dance?
Where do hamburgers go to dance?
Where do hamburgers go to dance?
A meatball.
A meatball. Ah, all right. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Huh? Do you think some of those are corny? Kind of funny. Who can tell me, let me real quick here, who can tell me real fast some of, in the Bible, of the fruit of the Spirit? Tell me what some of that is. Tell me some of the fruit of the Spirit is what?
Apple.
No. Fruit of the Spirit is love. Teachers, help them out. And joy. And peace. Huh? Patience. And kindness. Who said kindness? All right. And tell me what? Kindness is right. And self-control. How about, I like that, kindness. Kindness means this, that you're nice to people, right? All right, so I want you to be nice to the person next to you, okay? All right, Morgan has got a song she wants to share with you tonight. I think you kids might know this. Some of you might know it. So I want you to sing along with us. Where is Morgan? Come on up, girl. Are you ready? I want y'all to know that Morgan's fiance is here tonight. Let's embarrass her. Tyler, stand up, Tyler. Where are you, buddy? There he is. Y'all look right there. Give him a big hand for being here tonight, okay? Came all the way from Arkansas to be with us, or with her maybe, but with us. Not her, us. Right? Right, Tyler? Right. All right, here you go, honey.
Hey, are you guys having fun at VBS tonight?
Yeah!
That's what I like to hear. Y'all probably recognize me from over there at the Crave Cafe. How was y'all's food? Yeah! I thought I got a 5-star rating. Yeah! 5-star, thank you, thank you. 2? Sit down. 10? Thank you. Okay. Okay, now, here's the thing. With this song, I need y'all to help me, okay? Don't tell me no. Now, we're going to do it. I'm going to sing something, and then you have to sing it back. Got it? Can you guys do that? If I say something, you got to say it back, okay? So, but it's going to be this side against this side. So who can do it better? Okay, so everybody stand up. Y'all, Pastor Mark's good. Come on, everybody stand up. Okay, I need all y'all to stand up. Come on, we're going to see who can do this the best. Come on, stand up. Come on, guys, stand up. Come on, I know y'all got this. Come on, stand up. Okay, let's go, Brother John. Are you ready?
Said, whose side are you leaning on?
Leaning on the Lord's side.
I said, whose side are you leaning on?
Ski.
You did awesome tonight. You may be seated. I have to tell you, as the judge of the church, because I'm the pastor, this side won. Yeah. Y'all won over here? Did you get you guys won over here? Okay. All right. I tell you what we're going to do. Well, we're at the tiebreaker, okay? We'll do this first. On this side, when I say one, two, three, I want you to yell Jesus as loud as you can, okay? Are you ready, guys? On this side, you're going to yell Jesus. One, two, three. Okay. All right, on this side over here, I want you to whisper Jesus. Whisper. I'm a good judge. Whisper Jesus, right? Yeah. All right, on the count of three, you're going to, one. You don't want, no, I want you to yell. Tyra is going to yell Jesus back here. Tyra, look at this young lady right here. She's got a set of lungs that can reach to New York City. All right, Tyra, you can do this. Yeah, that's right. On three, yell Jesus, loud as you can. One, two, three. Okay, that's a tie. Okay, I tell you what, all together, both sides, yell Jesus. One, two, three. Okay. You guys did good. Wow, okay. Now that we got that passed, we're doing good. All right. Okay, kids, listen up. What'd y'all think of the skit last night? Wasn't that awesome? Huh? Guess what? I found out that Randy and the waitress, they kind of like each other. And you know they liked each other so much, they went off and got married. They got married. Randy and the waitress got married. I tell you what, it must have been the French fries. Okay. Randy went off, you know, and he's like, man, he got so hungry. All the other places were closed, so they had to come back. We were gone by that time. And so he had a hamburger and some bacon fries. And then he got a wife. All right. They did an awesome job yesterday. Okay, everybody quiet real quick. Here we go. Everybody quiet. Whoosh. Quiet. Everybody take a deep breath. You ready? Deep breath. All right. Here we go. Really important. I need 15 minutes. I need 15 minutes of you paying attention. 15 minutes, okay? Sister Jan's going to come up, and she's got a very important message to give you. Very important. 15 minutes. Sister Jan, come on. I think these kids are ripe and ready.
Thank you. Hey, guys. I'm so glad to see you tonight. Like he said, we need 15 minutes of your attention, okay? So we're going to see, instead of who can be the very loudest, we're going to see who can be the quietest. Have you guys ever played the quiet game?
Yeah.
All right. So listen. If you talk during the quiet game, unless you're asked to talk, guess what? You're out, right? Don't mess it up for your side, okay? Don't. Who is that? Him? Okay, I see him. All right. So we're going to play the quiet game, okay? Oh. Oh. What? What just happened? Wow. I think what happened is Miss Morgan forgot her hat. Look at that. We'll just set that back there. That's okay. All right. So boys and girls, all this VBS, we have been hearing a certain song. This side over here is losing right now. There, you guys are way behind in the quiet game. All right. I'm sorry, Abby. I know. I'm sorry, girl. It's not you. All right. So we have been having certain scriptures. We have had a song for God so loved the world, right? Yeah, every day. Well, look up on your screen. They're on both sides, guys. Can you read? Now, when you're playing the quiet game, but I ask you to talk, you're allowed to talk, okay? But we're going to read that scripture at the top together. Are you ready? Yes. Let's read it together. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16. Wow, that was wonderful. Guess what we're going to do? Can you guess? Yeah, English Standard Version. That's what that means. Can you guess what we're going to do next? We're going to read the next one, okay? All right, here we go. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Matthew 5:6. Wow, you guys did fantastic. I mean, awesome. Hey, I want to ask you a question. How many of you were here yesterday? Just like Pastor said, yeah, you were here yesterday. So if you were here yesterday, you can put your hands down now. But you guys, do you remember what happened to Randy? Yeah. He came in to the Crave Cafe, didn't he? And he came in to get a drink. Can you act like you're drinking something? He wanted a drink, and he wanted something to eat, right? Because he was hungry. But guess what? Poor Randy, he left, and he was still kind of thirsty because he never got a Diet Coke. And he was still hungry, right? Yeah, he got a water, but he didn't get what he wanted. Now, boys and girls, I brought up Randy because I want to encourage you. Don't be disappointed like Randy was, okay? We don't want you boys and girls to come to the Crave Cafe and to leave hungry or thirsty, all right? We don't want you to do that, okay? Randy was disappointed. We don't want you to be disappointed, right? Right. We don't want you to leave not satisfied. Now, last night, Isaiah, Randy had a really big problem. But guess what? All of us, we have an even bigger problem than Randy had. Can you imagine? Can you think about what our big problem might be? It starts with an S. It's a little short word. Sin. Yeah, does anybody know what sin is? If you want to answer, wait till I call on you. Let me see. Do you know what sin is? What is it?
From the devil when he gets in your body.
Oh my goodness. She said that's from the devil. Oh my god. It's definitely not from God, is it? But sin, I'll take one more that wants to try to answer. Landon, would you like to try?
It's a rule that you broke from God.
Oh, he said it's a rule that you broke from God. I like that, Landon. I want you guys to do this with me, okay? Watch. Sin is anything that we think. Touch your head. It's anything we think or we say, right, with your mouth, or we do, like fighting, that breaks God's law. That's what Landon was saying. He was saying that when we break the rules that God gives us, that's sin. And sin is a big problem because sin separates us from God. We don't want, yes, separates. I like the way you said that. It separates us from God, okay? Now, we know that Randy had a big problem, all right? His problem was that he was hungry. You know what? Actually, I didn't have dinner before I came. I'm kind of hungry too. So I hope you guys don't mind if I eat while I'm talking to you. Is that all right? Is that okay? Hey. Hey, what's going on here? What is this? What is that? What? Can anybody guess what this is? Anybody? Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. I said, if you would like to answer a question, raise a quiet hand. And some of you are not raising a quiet hand. It's a very noisy hand. All right, who can tell me what this is? Holden, what do you think this is? Oh, you think, well, it kind of looks like pizza, but it doesn't smell like pizza. You think it's paper? Yeah, I don't think it's real. Look at this. Oh, man. It's kind of, oh, it's stale pizza? Oh, my goodness. I don't think I should eat this. But guess what? This right here, you know what it actually is? It's a sponge. What? It's a sponge. Yeah, watch this. Watch this. I'm going to show you guys something, okay? I'll keep talking when you are listening. Good job, guys. Fantastic. All right. So listen. I'm going to show you something. So this is a sponge, I promise. It's a dry sponge, and it's not very useful. Do you think I can clean much with this? I might use it as a loofah. It might be hard enough for that. But it's a dry sponge. And like this, it's just flat, and it's dry, and it's empty, and it's kind of useless, right? Well, guess what? This sponge really shows what we're like, what our lives are like without Jesus. They're dry and empty and kind of useless. Yeah, hard too, right? Hard-hearted. Yeah, very good. So I'm going to show you something with this, okay? You ready? When Jesus comes into our life, something amazing happens, all right? This right here represents the living water. Jesus is the living water. So when we come in contact, when we believe in Jesus, right? Our scripture says when we believe in Jesus, he gives us new life. So watch what happens when I put that in there. Look what happened. This sponge, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Now it's moist and it's flexible. Look at that. And it's full. It's no longer dry. Look at, and it's pretty useful now. Isn't that so cool? Hang on, I'm not taking questions yet, buddy. Hold on just a minute, okay? Now, boys and girls, guess what? Did you know that Jesus invites you kids to come to him to satisfy your spiritual hunger and thirst? But before you'll do that, you have to realize your need for the living water and the bread of life. You have to know that you need Jesus, okay? Now, you also have to believe that Jesus is the only one who can satisfy you, okay? When you're hungry and thirsty spiritually, he's the only one who can satisfy you. Now, you also need to believe he's the only one that can solve your big problem of sin, okay? When you believe in Jesus, our scripture says when we believe in him, that we will have new life, kind of like this sponge, right? Now, Jesus is the living water. Jesus is the bread of life. And Jesus is the word of life, the Bible, okay? He is the word. Now, if you believe in Jesus and you take in the living water and you eat of the bread of life and you let that word completely satisfy you, the Bible says you will begin to crave. We're at Crave Cafe, guys. You will begin to crave the milk of the word. And that's so that you can grow in your salvation or in your friendship with Jesus. If you've never believed in Jesus and let him give you new life, right here needs an adult. Right here. Thank you. If you've never believed in Jesus and you've never asked him to come into your life so that you could experience the living water, I invite you today to come and let Jesus quench your thirst and satisfy your hunger, those empty places in your life. I don't want you to leave. None of these teachers that are here, our pastor, we don't want you to leave the Crave Cafe still hungry and unsatisfied, okay? But we want you to invite Jesus into your life, okay? In the Bible, Jesus actually said, if anyone is thirsty, let him come to me. Okay? Anyone who thirsts, let him come to me. And he also said this. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. And he said, whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty, shall never thirst. You girls and you boys know that when you're thirsty and you drink water, later you're thirsty again, right? But Jesus says if you drink of the water that he will give to you, that you'll never thirst again, because Jesus can satisfy you completely. He can satisfy you, okay? So I want to ask a question. It's really important, okay? So I need everybody back to the quiet game. You're really doing fantastic. I'm really happy with you. But let's be real quiet. Not yet. Hold on. If you have never, ever believed in Jesus for new life, okay? For God so loved the world, that's every person that he's ever created. He loves you so much that he gave his only son, that's Jesus, that whoever, right, anybody who wants to, whoever believes in him, should not perish or be separated from him, okay? But will have eternal life or new life. So I want you boys and girls, this is what I want you to do. If you want to ask Jesus to forgive your sin and you want to ask him to give you new life, I just want you to show all of us here at the Crave Cafe by raising your hand. Anybody that says, I want to believe in Jesus, I want this water that you're talking about. I want to have a hunger and a thirst that only Jesus can satisfy. Okay, so those of you that raised your hand, okay, you can put them back down now. I just want to let you know that we're going to pray together, okay? And it's not really the words that you say. It's that you mean it in your heart when we're praying. So I'm going to pray and you can pray too, okay? You ready? So if you want to bow your head and close your eyes, if you're going to pray to believe in Jesus, okay, for new life that lasts forever. Dear Jesus, I know that I have sinned, but I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Please give me the living water. Please cause me to hunger for you. And please help me to be in your word, to hunger and thirst for righteousness, so that I may be satisfied. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Now, real quick, that was amazing. Real quick, before we go outside, I want to know, if there's any of the children in here that want to come forward to say, I believed in Jesus, If you want to come forward to show that you believed in Jesus, come, go ahead and come up here with Miss Jan. And then what we're going to do is our team leaders and our teachers are going to come up and pray for these kids right now. I'm going to give this over to you, Pastor. Do you mind leading in prayer?
All right, kiddos. If you want to come up here to make a stand and say, I believe in Jesus, I prayed this prayer, and I want to live my life for him, you're more than welcome. Nobody is forced to do this, only if you want to. I believe in Jesus, and I want to live my life for him. Praise God. There's no greater life to live than live your life for Jesus. All right. Aren't they precious? Aren't they precious? Praise God. Amen. I'm going to ask the team leaders to gather around these kids. All right. Gather around these children, and let's pray for them, okay? Praise God. Church, extend your hand out. Pray with them as well, all right? They're precious in God's sight. Heavenly Father, we are so very grateful and thank you for these children. God, I know that you love them. There's a war, Lord Almighty God, that's coming against these children the day that we're living in right now. But I pray, Father, thanking you that all these kids have made a confession of faith, that they said they believe in Jesus and they want to live their lives for you, Lord. I pray that you would help them. Thank you, God, that you are the one that has washed their sins away, given them a new life. And I pray, Father, God, that you would just protect them, guide them, lead them. I pray that they will hunger for Jesus more than anything else in this life, in this world. I know that we're not perfect. We make mistakes, but I'm thank you that you're there to help us through our troubled times. Father, we need you. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you for these children, Father. Thank you for all the leaders. Thank you for everybody that spent time investing into these kids. Bless them, their homes, their lives, their families. God, draw them to you, I pray. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Praise God. Oh, you kids are awesome. You kids are awesome. You go sit down real quick. Praise God. I tell you, there's nothing like living your life for the Lord Jesus. There's nothing like selling out to God. You know? Real quick, let's have a seat, and we're gonna dismiss you in a moment. But come on. All right, come on, sit down real quick, okay? Real quick. All right. I want to ask you something. If you go into the store and say you want to buy a candy bar, say your favorite candy bar is a Twix. You guys like Twix? You like Twix? Twix are good, you know? And what if you paid full price for that Twix candy bar, and so you went up to the register, you paid for it, and the person said, wait a minute, they ripped the package in half and only gave you half the candy bar. Would you be okay with that? Yeah. You'd be okay? So you'd say, oh, I'm happy about that because they only gave you half a candy bar? No, you'd be upset. Say, wait a minute, I paid full price. I gave you money for a whole candy bar, but you're only giving me half. And you say, well, you know what? You feel kind of cheated out, don't you? Would you say you feel cheated out? What if you went and bought a whole pizza and you came home and they only gave you half? Would you feel cheated out? Yeah. Let me tell you this. I wonder how Jesus feels if we only give him half our heart. I wonder how Jesus feels if we only give him half our heart. You know what? God wants all your heart, doesn't he? So Sister Jan was sharing with you how you can give God all your heart tonight and how you can believe in Jesus and how you can live your life for him, okay? A couple things we're going to do. First of all, kids, we don't have teams tonight. We're all on the same team. We have barbecued hot dogs out here, and you're allowed to get one hot dog, one bag of chips, one water. One hot dog, one bag of chips, one water. No food or... Listen, no trash on the ground. There are three trash cans, one out in the field, one by the fence here, and one right here at the Crave Cafe. You can sit down at the tables at the Crave Cafe. You can sit down at the picnic tables over here. You can sit down on the ground. That's fine. But I just want you to know that you can come and get something to eat, okay? Free of charge, all right? No charge. Praise God. Okay. And then also we have the bouncy house out here in the back. You cannot go on the bouncy house with your shoes. You have to take your shoes off. There'll be people there helping you, But make sure that you pick your shoes back up. Now listen, kids, listen. No jumping on top of each other, sliding or diving on top of each other. Hold it. Listen. Quiet, 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 quiet. Shh. Quiet, quiet, quiet. No jumping on each other, no tackling each other, no diving on each other. Take your time. Take your turn. No shoes on the slide, but you got to get your shoes when you're finished. And after we eat and after the slide, we're going to have the game. We're going to have the prize giveaway. Some of the guys might be playing catch with football out there is fine, but we need your cooperation, okay? We got nearly 100 kids here tonight. We need your cooperation. Okay. I told them nothing. No Rangers and Missionettes next Wednesday or the next, okay? We're canceling for 2 weeks, okay? Not next Wednesday or the next because it's fair week. We got the fair going on. We never have Rangers during that time. So we appreciate all you kids coming. We hope you learned something. I hope that you'll be very thankful and grateful for what everybody has done. All the prizes, all the food, all the time, all the games, all the crafts. Great time. Really, really enjoyed this. But most of all, I pray that you got the message about hungering and thirsting for more of Jesus and living your life for Him. Okay. Yep. All the adult team leaders, we need you to help everywhere. We'll need you to, I need some adult team leaders, a couple of them at the slide when they're getting on, and then I need one or two when they're getting off, okay? And make sure that we don't cut in line. It's a bad habit some kids have, cutting in line. Do not cut in line. You'll get your turn, okay? Everybody cooperate. Also, we have some at the food station here. We need help. And we need a few at the prize booth. We need some help there as well. And also just helping cleaning up, picking up after the kids as well, okay? All right, kiddos, team leaders. All right, if you, let's stand up, okay? Let's stand up. We got an hour and 5 minutes to do this. We've got an hour and five. About 9 o'clock, we're going to load up. About 9 o'clock, we're going to load up. Okay, team leaders, okay. They're going to come out here. All right. I want you kids to walk out. Listen, don't run. And make sure there's a restroom out here. Walk, walk. Bring everything with you. We're not coming back into the church. Bring everything with you. Okay. Okay. Bring everything with you and walk nicely. Very good. Very good. Okay. Walk. Out the back. Walk quiet, nicely. Okay. Guac.